Welcome to this Nedbank Financial Market Educational Series, proudly brought to you by our online share trading division. In this educational series, we will discuss various topics related to financial markets. Learning about trading and investing is essential for every client, as this will equip you to make more informed personal trading and investing decisions. In this session, we will cover what you need to know and do once you are ready to place a trade. Please note that this session is on both a beginner and an intermediate level. Before we start, please refer to our disclaimer. In summary, you cannot regard this session as any trading or investment advice, as it is provided for educational purposes only. Let us commence the session. Once you have logged into your account at onlineshare-trading.nedbank.co.za, there are four places on the site from which you can access the trading screen. On the dashboard and portfolio tabs, you will see a trade button next to your account name and number. While on the Research Center and Watchlist tabs, you will see three small dots in line with the data on the right-hand side of the screen. If you click on these dots, a shortcut pop-up menu will open. Selecting Trade on this menu will take you to the trading screen. Before placing a trade, there are a number of key terms you need to understand. Firstly, let's define buy and sell. To buy is to place an order on the market to purchase a stock or share, whether it is a new stock or an addition to your current holdings. Another term for buying is to go long on a stock. This terminology is used most often when trading on the derivatives market. To go long is to buy a stock or instrument with the expectation that the share price will increase. To sell is to place an order on the market to sell a stock or share. Another term for selling is to short the stock. When trading on the derivatives market, if you short sell, you are selling a stock or instrument with the expectation that the share price will decrease. Secondly, let's look at the bid price versus the offer price. When trading, a bid price is the highest price a buyer is willing to pay for a single share of a given stock. The offer price or ask price, on the other hand, is the lowest price a seller is willing to accept for a single share of the stock. Thirdly, it's important to understand the difference between a market price and a limit price. The market price of a stock is the price that it sells for on the open market at a given point in time. The market price will usually fluctuate throughout the day as investors buy and sell stocks. The market price will rise if more people want to buy it and fall as people begin selling more of the stock. The limit price is an order placed by a trader to buy or sell a stock at a specific price or better. A buy limit order can be executed only at the limit price or lower, and a sell limit order can be executed only at the limit price or higher. A limit order is not guaranteed to be executed. If you are looking for information on what to trade, under the Research Center tab on the site, you will find long-term fundamental research on various companies, as well as short-term trading ideas. Please bear in mind that trading ideas are time sensitive, and to reap the benefits, you need to action them within the time period recommended in the research. You can access the trading screen directly from the Research Center by clicking on the three small dots on the right of the research list. Once you have clicked on the trade link, a trading window will open containing the fields you need to complete in order to place the trade. Under instrument type, you need to select the market you would like to trade on, either contract for difference, known as CFD, or equities. The CFD option will only be available if you have registered for a CFD account. The brackets after the instrument type indicate whether the market is currently open or closed. The market does not need to be open for you to submit an order. If you submit an order outside of trading hours, the order will be saved and then sent to the market once it opens. Your account name and number will reflect in the trade from account text box. If you have more than one account linked to your profile, you can click on the drop-down and select the account you would like to trade from. Your available funds in that account will be displayed just below the text box. You now need to enter the name of the instrument you want to trade into the instrument name text box. As soon as you complete the instrument name text box, the box on the right-hand side of the screen will populate with market information about the instrument you have selected. In the market data area, the price in the top left corner is the latest price of the instrument in the market at the date and time displayed below the price. Share prices are always displayed in cents, so a share price of 17855C equates to R178.55. The figures at the bottom of this box show the open, high, low, close, and volume information for this instrument, while the movement, indicated to the right of the share price, displays the daily movement of the share compared with the previous day's closing price. For example, this instrument closed at 17787 cents and is currently trading at 17855 cents. This is a movement of 68 cents, and the movement percentage of 0.38% is displayed in brackets. To refresh this data, click on the reload link. Underneath this is the market depth information. Here you can see bids or buy orders submitted by buyers wanting to buy the share and offers or sell orders submitted by sellers who want to sell the share that are currently in the market. The first line will always show the highest bid and the lowest offer. This information will help you decide at what price you want to enter the market. The latest trades information displays confirmed trades that took place in the market for the share and the time that these took place. Armed with this market information, you can now decide whether you want to buy or sell the share. If you select Buy, information will appear under the order volume text box to advise you of the estimated number of shares you will be allowed to buy. This is based on the funds you have available for trade and the last traded market price or the limit price you may have placed on the order. Please note, this estimate does not consider the fees applicable to the trade. If you select Sell, the information will display your current holdings or the number of shares in that instrument that you currently have in your portfolio. You may also see a DMAT quantity. This displays the number of shares registered or settled in your name. The share settlement period of the JSE is T plus 3, in other words, the day traded plus 3 working days. This means purchased shares or the proceeds from share sales will only reflect in your account 3 working days after the day the trade has been made. The next step is to decide the order type, and here is where the concept of market price and limit price that we discussed earlier comes into play. To recap, a market order is a trade to buy or sell immediately at the current price in the market. A limit order allows traders to buy or sell the share at a set price in the future. A limit order will only execute a trade if the price reaches the predefined levels. The order will not be filled if the price does not reach this level. If you have placed a market order, it is valid for the current trading day only. If you have placed a limit order, you can choose the life of the order by stipulating a period for your order to be valid. Once you have captured the details of your order, the order summary will be populated on the right-hand side of the screen. The order summary is a written description of the order you're trying to place. You should always read it before submitting your order. The order summary carries the following information. The projected cost breakdown shows the number of shares multiplied by the market or limit price stipulated. The projected fee breakdown shows the various fees that will be charged on the trade. Projected total cost of trade is calculated by adding the above costs. Projected funds available after the trade will show the cash remaining in your trading account after the estimated trade costs have been deducted. In the top right-hand corner of this block is a disclaimer link which will provide you with additional information on how broker fees are calculated and applied. If you are not happy with the order summary, you can go back to the input fields and change the information you have inserted. If you are happy with the trade you have captured and the fees in your order confirmation, select the confirmation tick box and click on the Submit Trade Order button. Once the trade has been submitted, the order is sent to the JSE trading engine, where it will be traded. The trading engine will send different messages back depending on the outcome of the order. You can view the status of your orders at any time under the Orders tab. Status updates will include the following. New means the order is in the market and waiting to be traded. Filled means the order has been completed and the full volume of shares has been traded. Partially filled means the full volume of the order has not yet been traded. The status will show expired when the date set on the life of the order has passed. If the status shows cancelled, the order has been cancelled from the market. If the status shows partially cancelled, then a portion of the volume has been traded and the remaining volume has been cancelled from the market. And if an order shows rejected, it means that the order submitted has not satisfied certain trading rules and has been prevented from entering the market. Once the order has been either matched or completely filled, it will be displayed on the portfolio screen. So what action is required from you? If your order is new or has been filled, no action is required from you. If your order has been partially filled, expired, cancelled, or partially cancelled, and you still wish to trade, a new order needs to be submitted. And if your order has been rejected and you still wish to trade, you need to examine the trade submitted to determine which rules were not satisfied. A new amended trade which satisfies the trading rules would then need to be submitted. We have reached the end of this series of Getting Started videos. We hope you have found the information useful and that you are now ready to start trading. This educational video was brought to you by Nedbank Online Share Trading. Any examples used in this session are purely for illustrative purposes. Thank you for your time.